Hey guys, Jim here. Welcome in once again. Today we're going to do something vastly different. We're going to be looking at something completely different than I generally ever show on my channel. And as a matter of fact, I'm going to get a chance right now to say something that I typically don't say outside of the bedroom, which is, let me unzip this, whip it out, and amaze you with this incredible size. All right. What we're going to be taking a look at today is the incomparable PMP Knives Alpha Beast. And when I say incomparable, it's because of this. A 0.04 of an inch thick blade. That's just a hair under a half an inch. It's just a hair over an inch and a quarter from the presentation side slab to the pocket clip. It is massive in every possible way, but I honestly think that it's more than just a conversation starter. You know, a lot of times we'll buy novelties like this just to have something unique, not because we're going to carry it all the time or we're going to use it for practical cutting purposes. I mean, almost a half inch thick blade, you're not going to be cutting too much before the blade just gets too thick to be practical. But we don't always buy things based on practicality. We buy a car that accelerates far too quickly and is going to get us nothing but traffic tickets. We buy into lots of things that are utterly ridiculous. And we do it just because of the enjoyment that we're going to get out of how unique that item is, the reaction other people are going to give to it when we hand it to them or show it to them, or just there's some childlike quality in us that just goes, I just want to buy it because it's different and it's cool and it makes me smile for some reason. This is not going to be your EDC knife. I mean, it weighs almost a full pound. We'll double check that here in a minute. And it's incredibly thick. It's like putting a 2x4 section in your pocket. There is nothing practical about this. I don't want you to think that I'm going to be here trying to justify how you can use this as an EDC knife. That's not what this is about. This is about an exercise in, hey, it would be pretty cool if we could try to do this. And they did it, and they did it extraordinarily well. As a matter of fact, I don't think that there are very many overbuilt knives that can compete in the two areas that shocked me the most about this knife. And no, it wasn't just the thickness. It is the thickest knife that I know of that folds. But it's the build quality and certain things that it does and how it feels that I gotta tell you, they put way more effort into it than I would have expected for a knife of this type. So I'm not gonna waste any more time and babble on because this is gonna be a long video just talking about the details of the knife and showing it in comparison to more normal EDC style knives. I gotta tell you, I was very, very surprised by a couple of things, and I think that you will be as well. Now, before we get to that, please do like and subscribe and all that stuff. Subscribe to the channel. It's just going to do you good. But the other thing is, if you're not already a patron, if you're not part of my Patreon group, you might want to consider doing it, I don't know, now, because the next few giveaways that I'm doing are going to be utterly insane. For January, there's going to be a full handmade custom knife in there in the giveaway. You can only win it if you are a Patreon member. I've got the link right down here. And then there's going to be, I don't really want to say what next month's is just yet, but trust me, it's going to surprise and amaze quite a number of you, and you're going to want that knife in your collection. So without any further ado, let's go downstairs, get some close-up looks at the PMP Knives Alpha Beast, and see what makes this not just a curio, but something I honestly think that you're going to want in your collection. We'll have to see about that. Take a look right now. Okay, now it's time for a little bit of close-up action. Not like you couldn't see this monster from a distance, but it's important to really get an idea of just how insane this knife is. Listen, you're watching this video for one of only a couple reasons. One, morbid curiosity. Two, to make fun of people and manufacturers who enjoy unbelievably oversized, overthick, crazy, overbuilt knives. Or third, you're actually interested in crazy overbuilt knives or curios, things that are just unique and different from everything else out there that's cookie cutter in the industry, and you just like owning interesting, unique, cool shit. Well, this video hopefully is going to satisfy everybody. Let's start with the basics. 9 1/4 inches in overall length. It's a beast. It's a 4-inch long blade in Nylock steel. We'll discuss Nylocks in a few minutes. But what really makes it special is this. 0.04 inch thick. Now, to put that in perspective, that's just a hair under a 0.5 inch thick. It's insane. It's crazy. It's heavy. It's beefy. It's chunky. It's everything that you can throw at it and more. But here's where it gets weird. It's really, really well built. It's really nicely made. And we'll discuss that again in a couple minutes as well. So PMP Knives is owned by Patrick Hollenstein, and the company's been around for about 6 years. And their real claim to fame is stuff like this, making crazy oversized folding knives that are outrageous in some way, generally just because of their size. And this goes back to the original Beast, and this really is to one up the original Beast. The Beast was big and thick and crazy, but Patrick decided to go all the way into insanity and make this one. And to be honest with you, I don't know of a thicker folder. Somebody mentioned in my Instagram post where I started doing the sneak peek pictures of this. They're like, because the picture they commented on was just the knife like this. They're like, oh, you got a Medford. I'm like, no, dude, if you took a Medford and stacked it on top of another Medford, you'd pretty much have this. This is way thicker than the Praetorian tie. It's like I said, it's the thickest, beefiest folder that I've ever seen. There may be others out there that are as thick. There may be others out there that are even thicker. I don't know of them. This is the biggest one that I've seen. And any of those that do exist were probably one-offs, or they made 5 of them or something like that. This is going to be a production knife, albeit a limited production, but it will be put into production. So let me tell you right off the bat, of course it's drop shutty. The friggin' blade weighs a ton. This thing could be bolted together, titanium on steel with no bearings, and I bet that thing would drop shut. I almost pooped in my pants when I first got it. And I'm like, oh, let's see what the action's like when I drop shut it. And I barely got my thumb out of the way. And I realized, oh my God, that would have been one hell of a cut. That would have been a hell of an injury. But putting that obvious part aside, here's what amazed me the most about this knife, besides the obvious dimensions, is the fact that the detent is perfect. Even though that is a thick, weighty blade, you cannot get that blade to shake out. The detent is perfect, but it's not so overly strong that you can't just flick it open. The balance between the weight of the blade, the detent strength, the strength of the tension of the lock bar is absolutely perfect. It flicks open with the greatest of ease, but you can't make that blade fly out. Folks, that's almost straight up and down with the enormous weight of that blade, and it still goes all the way to full lock. Very, very little effort required. To me, that's impressive as shit. All right, let's do something here. This is ridiculous. Let's see how much this thing weighs. Are you kidding me? That is just under a full pound. 15.8 ounces. Let's just for comparison's sake. There's a hammer. There's your new folding knife. That's insanity. Let's give you some comparisons against other knives that people consider to be beastly, beastly folders. Here is my Diamondback V2 from DSK Knives. 6.5 ounces. And I'm going to give you some direct comparisons on that in a second. Here is the Sniper Blade Works LPC. 7.4 ounces. That's a chunky monkey right there. Varga Knives VBR. 5 ounces. And these are all pretty standard common sizes. And here's something a little smaller just to be funny. 2.5 ounces in the Synapse Mini from Vero Engineering. So now we have the weight out of the way. Oops. Let's take a look at the size differences. Let me put it down, clip side up. Now again, this is a beefy, chunky, thick knife. DSK Tactical is very well known for that. The Alpha Beast dwarfs it in every conceivable way. Let's take a look at it this way. Look at that shit. Look at the difference there. This is a thick, beefy folder. And it looks like I'm putting a hinderer up next to it. It's insane. Let's do this. Guys, that's crazy. Then you take the Sniper Blade Works LPC. You take a very common folder size in the VBR. And then, of course, the little tiny Vero. You cannot compare it to anything else. Can't be done. Here, look at this. That's the massiveness that you're dealing with. Look at this. The entire Synapse is slimmer than the actual blade stock alone on the Alpha Beast. Nutty. Crazy. Insane. But the workmanship is fantastic. Very fine stonewash. Really awesome grinds. I like the milled slots that are in the flats. And I wonder if that was a stylistic choice or just a, oh my God, this blade is just too heavy. We got to take some weight out of it choice. Nice chamfer going down the spine of the blade. Nice big bevel there. The one change I think I would make to make it slightly more practical is this is flat ground on the primary bevel. Honestly, you know with a blade that gets this thick, this ain't a slicer. This ain't made for that. This is, I mean, you're going to hack through shit. You're going to cut into stuff. But at some point, this material is getting so thick and so wide that a lot of stuff, cutting down cardboard boxes and stuff, this isn't going to be the best choice for it. The suggestion that I would make when these go into production is I really would love to see at least the primary grind being hollow ground. Number one, it's going to get much, much thinner and stay thinner for a longer period of time before it swells out to its ultimate thickness. I would even probably raise the grind up just a little bit, just to give it a little bit more room to do that. Now, the benefit of Nylock steel is the fact that it's a tool steel. It's very, very much like D2. The difference between Nylocks and D2, they're both made for hard cutting. They're not made for fine slicing and things like that. They are a tool steel. It's made to be tough. It's got very large carbides. You're not going to get down to a razor thin edge and have an edge that's going to hold up. But Nylox does have better edge retention, slightly, than D2, and far better corrosion resistance. The main reason people don't like D2 is that it rusts easily, and the carbide structure is so large they can't get a super fine edge. You're not going to get a super fine edge here with the Nylox either. It's still going to be a good edge. If this were a hollow ground, this would actually be more impressive as an everyday cutter. But it's going to be highly corrosion resistant. It's going to have much more wear resistance than D2. Let's just cut a piece of paper. Let's just see if it's even sharp. It felt kind of sharp to me, just kind of touching the edge. Yeah, it's actually not too bad. Now, again, you got to keep in mind, this is a prototype. Patrick did tell me because this was not sharpened to the degree that, you know, a production knife would be. But you see the limitations. So you could still push cut. It's still sharp enough for that. But you see the limitations as we get to the thicker portions of the blade, even just in paper. So imagine cutting something thick and with great friction resistance like cardboard. But you're not buying this to be practical anyway. You're buying it to carry this enormous fucking hammer in your pants and pull it out in front of somebody and they go, holy shit. And then also be able to cut and chop stuff. You'll be able to do all that. And you're going to get a lot of holy shit reactions out of it as well. Let's take another closer look at this. So here is the really, really nice stonewash texture. It's got a little bit of reflectivity to it. It's a nice bright stonewash. Enormous thumb studs. Nice big pivot. I'm glad they kept the pivot kind of plain. Didn't overdo it with the design. All the edges all the way around the handle are very gently contoured. This is actually not an uncomfortable knife in the hand. Yeah, it's big and it's chunky. It's about an inch and a quarter from one side of the titanium to the clip. So it's over an inch and a quarter in overall thickness. So it's going to be a really, really, really big handful. But it's not uncomfortable at all. Everything's rounded nicely. The jimping here is very wide set jimping. It's not very sharp. It's pretty effective, but it's not the best I've seen. If they left a little more edge to each of the individual teeth, they did. Oh, you know what? I just noticed that. They just barely rounded off all of the jimping. Not entirely certain why they chose to do that. It reduces how effective it's going to be. I would leave those a little bit sharper. I would do a hollow grind on the primary bevel here. And I think you would actually have a knife that's a little bit more than just a conversation piece. Oh, I guess we should show the grinding there. Really nicely done. Look at the centering. By the way, notice the enormous channel going through the massive titanium backspacer. Perfectly centered. Now, this is unmarked because it is a prototype. There's no maker's mark for PMP knives, nor the manufacturer that's actually going to be building these. I've been asked not to disclose who's going to be making it just for right now. That's going to change very, very shortly. But until he actually places the order with them, he's not allowed to say, oh, it's going to be made by this factory. once the order is placed and they're conducting business, it's not going to be a secret. You'll be able to check out my Instagram. You'll be able to check out PMP Knives Instagram. All the information will be there. But as of right now, while this is still just a prototype, I think he only has two or three prototypes. One was stolen in the mail. That sucks. While it's still in the prototype stage, I'm not allowed to say who it is. I will put your mind at ease, though, by telling you it is a really, really, really high-quality manufacturer that you've seen on my channel before that have made nothing but fantastic knives. Nobody will be disappointed. What he's going to be doing is setting up a pre-order for these, because these are extraordinarily expensive to build. These massive titanium slabs are expensive. The Nylock steel is expensive, so in this thickness and this size. So he is going to be doing a pre-order. He's only looking to fill a couple dozen spots before he puts it into production. So you're not going to have to wait too long to wait for that order list to fill up. Honestly, I think it's going to fill up in the first couple of days after this video uploads. I posted some pictures on Facebook and Instagram, and a lot of people went, holy shit, I've got to have one of those, just for the novelty of owning it possibly, but I've got to own one of those. So I don't think it's going to take very long at all to get that order in. Everything about this is well built. The gear-shaped or the gear-patterned enormous titanium backspacer, the way the jimping matches up to the front and the back, the softening of the titanium edges, the retention of the pocket clip. It's not overly done, but it is very, very secure. I don't know a lot of people that are going to be able to fit this in their pocket comfortably. If you're wearing little bitch boy skinny jeans, this is not going to be the knife for you. It's not even going to fit in there. You do have a very large lanyard slot to put. I don't think you're going to need to put a lanyard on this. It is a little bit slick just because it's just bead blasted and stonewashed titanium. There's no real grip to it at all. What I'm going to be doing, because this is mine and it's a prototype, I'm going to actually take it down and I'm going to probably mill some lines into it, do some anodizing, some wild cool stuff to it, because I know this is not a knife I'm going to carry very often, hardly at all. But when I do, I kind of want it to be kind of a really wow showpiece besides just the size of it. So I'm going to be customizing mine over the next few months and doing some interesting little things. But I do want to do something with some milling, just to add a little bit more grip, a little bit more tactility to it. Again, man, this is not a knife that I'm going to seriously be using. But if I do pull it out of my pocket, I wouldn't want this giant, sharp, heavy piece of steel to fall out of my hand and land on somebody's foot or something like that. So, yeah, that's my thoughts on that. But there it is, the big, giant, crazy monster. When you get past the fact that it's overbuilt just to be overbuilt, because this knife will probably cut any other overbuilt knife in half, when you get past the novelty of that, it is important to stress how well made this is. The lock bar tension is perfect. The detent is perfect. The action is glass smooth. I mean, it just, yes, I understand. The weight of the blade is going to make it close anyway. But you can feel how smooth it is just by doing this. It is glass-like smooth. Bearings are very well done. And, yeah, the fact that you can just pop it open, and I'm not going to exaggerate this at all. It is as easy to flip open as a Sebenza. That's how little effort I'm putting into it. And when I first did that, I'm like, oh, wow, that's way easier than I thought it was going to be. I'm like, oh, man, that detent's going to be too light for such a heavy blade. And I started shaking the living shit out of it like that. And it doesn't move. It doesn't unseat from its closed position at all. And to me, that's probably the single most impressive thing about this knife is the fact that they tune that detent, that lock bar tension, everything perfectly. There, by the way, is the lockup, because I just realized I forgot to show that to you before. So it is early lockup, but you'll notice there's still quite a bit of lock engagement. So nothing to worry about there whatsoever. This thing is not going to collapse on you. So anyway, there it is in all of its massive glory. I hope you guys enjoyed the video as much as I've enjoyed playing with this bad boy. This is one you're going to see probably fairly often on my Instagram because, like I said, it's just fun to play with. I do like big, oversized knives. Here's the great thing. You know, the expected, estimated price is going to be somewhere around $499. You know, I'm holding a $1,300 custom in my hand right here. And I'm going to tell you right now, they feel very, very close in quality. This being more impressive just with the massive size of it. But yeah, you could spend a lot more. So for those that want to bulk it, oh my God, it's going to be $499. That's my rough estimation after talking with Patrick. Could be a couple bucks more, could be a couple bucks less. But if you keep in mind that it's going to be right around $500, I don't think that you're going to be disappointed when the actual pricing comes out. I think overall, it is a fantastic conversation piece. It holds very little for practicality. You're not buying this with the intention of carrying it every day and using it for predetermined tasks. It's just going to be a fun novelty to have with you, to have as a conversation piece, a show-off piece. You know, it's like having, you know, the guys that are going to buy the Tesla truck. There's going to be a lot of EV pickup trucks that are going to accelerate quickly and have 10,000-pound towing capacity and all that shit. But it's so ugly, it's cool. It's going to have, you know, stainless steel body panels that are supposedly bulletproof. Things like that that serve no actual purpose, but for you just to go, look how cool this is. Look how different this is. So, yeah, you could call this the Tesla truck of the knife industry, and I don't think that you'd be too far off. It does function the way that you would want it to. It feels higher quality than you expected. It just happens to have a birth defect. That's about the best way I can put it. All right, guys, that's enough talking for right now. I'm going to get on out of here. And I have quite a few videos I'm going to be uploading here very, very shortly. So definitely stay tuned and sign up to become a patron. You want to become a Patreon member now. Not going to tell you much about why, except the next couple of giveaways are pretty damn awesome. One, it's going to be full custom. I think you're going to dig it. All right, guys, I'm out of here. Thank you for watching, as always, and I'll see you on the next video.